For the last topic of this course, I will discuss this time and next time the prehistorical cultural exchange between Taiwan and other Southeast Asian cultures. First of subtopic for this plan is about the exchange of nephrite, a kind of jewelry product in Taiwan. The earrings made of nephrite will especially be explained in detail for the first to third chapters. And in the last chapter, I will introduce another nephrite culture in New Zealand. Based on chemical composition, we will look at the two separate kinds of green-colored jewelry, that is, nephrite, the soft one, and jadeite, the hard one. According to the research conducted by Dr. Iizuka Yoshiyuki of the Academia Sinica, the historical mines of these gemstones were found in many places throughout the eastern half of Asia and the Pacific area, as can be seen on this map. Among 29 mines, 25 of them were whole nephrite, one of which was in Taiwan. The first chapter is of nephrite in Taiwan. I will show you several prehistoric sites related to this topic, such as Shishanhan site in New Taipei City and the Huntian site in Hualien, the Penan site in Taitung and the Lanwei Island. The Huntian site is located in Hualien County. The left picture is a bird's-eye view of Hualien City and its southern suburb seen from the northeast direction. In this area, or in the northern part of Huatong Valley, runs the Hualien River. The right picture shows the downstream of Hualien River from a southern direction. 16 kilometers from the river mouth, the main stream of Hualien River turns to the western direction, such as shown in the left pictures. 8 kilometers from this point, Huntian can be reached at the central range area as seen in the right pictures. At the mountain, near this area of Hualien River, is the nephrite mine of in Taiwan. The gemstone of nephrite usually shows a whitish blue color or a spotted light green color. These two pictures are not of Taiwanese nephrite, but are of nephrite from Poland and Wyoming in USA. The appearance of Taiwanese nephrite is almost the same as these gemstones. Why is nephrite important? It is very closely related to the manufacturing of jewelry from the prehistoric period. 4 kilometers northwest of Taitung City, or west of Taitung Railway Station, is a very famous prehistoric site of Taiwan called the Penan Site, which is indicated by the yellow circle in the left pictures. After several rounds of archaeological excavation, the ruins of a wide graveyard and residence area from the Neolithic age were found here. A large part of residential or burial structures, many of which have been excavated, were made of stone. We can see this in the right pictures. Due to the importance of this site in understanding the prehistorical period of Taiwan, this site area is now known as the Penan Cultural Park and can be seen in the left pictures. The National Museum of Prehistory has been established here. Among the large number of findings in this site, it is important to note that several articles of jewelry were also discovered inside of some stone coffins. This includes the nephrite earring shown in the left picture. Basically, the earrings of Penang can be classified into two types. The most common is a ring with four projections. But as a rare example, there is also a type unearthed which depicts two standing humans with an animal. This can be seen in the right picture. Another important prehistoric site was found in Pari, New Taipei City, which has been named the Shishanhan site. This site is located at the coastal area close to mouth of the Danshui River. Here, a graveyard and some residential structures of the prehistoric period have been discovered. In the present times, a site museum has been established in this area, as seen in the left pictures. Among the large number of artifacts found in this site, the rare type of nephrite earring seen in Penang were also found here, such as shown in the right pictures. So it is clear that the earring made of Hentian nephrite had already spread from the south of Taiwan to the north. As an extension regarding these findings in Taiwan, I will explain the finding of nephrite earring in Vietnam for second chapter. Concerning this topic, we should visit Hoi An and Saphing in central Vietnam and Ho Chi Minh City in southern Vietnam. Along the long-distance coastal area of central Vietnam, we can see a beautiful scenery in many places, such as the wide lagoon, pure white sand beach, or the small island shown in the left pictures. And at the beaches of this area, it is not rare to see a very strange fishing boat with a bowl shape, such as seen in the right picture. At one such sand beach, a unique prehistoric culture was first to be discovered. After extensive archaeological excavation carried out under a thick sand hill, this area is called Saphing and is shown in the left and right pictures. Many similar sites continue to be discovered on the central and southern Vietnamese coast. This unique prehistoric coastal culture was named the Saphing culture. Almost all the findings of this culture are the same. That is, they contained many covered burial earthenware jars, such as seen in the right picture. In central Vietnam, there is a mountain area near the coast which can be easily reached, so this area is not well suited for agricultural production. Most of burial jar sites are found in the coastal sand hill area. Because of such findings, it is possible to think that the main area of cultural activity for these people were at sea. These pictures show the typical findings of earthenware of burial jars. A long vertical oval body is combined with a trapezoid cover. It is thought that the dating of this culture goes back to the first millennium BC. The remains of the inhabitants here were placed into these jars. Although a large part of the remains were also not found inside. As a very rare case, archaeologists succeeded in finding a skull inside of a jar at a site close to Ho Chi Minh City. It is very interesting to note that this skull had a nephrite earrings connected to its left side, as can be seen in these pictures. Because this site is located in a marsh area near to the coast, this skull has been kept in a relatively good condition due to the wet environment in which it was found. The people of the surfing culture used two styles of earrings. The left picture shows a type with an egg-like body and three triangular projections. The other style is formed of two animal heads with which join at the center. And this type is larger than the former style, which can be seen in the right picture. These earrings were made of nephrite, other stones, and glasses. The earrings found around the Ho Chi Minh City area, as seen in these pictures, are almost the same shape as the two kinds of earrings found in central Vietnam area, shown in the previous pictures. We can see very beautiful glass earring with a blue color in the bottom left of the left picture. Except for the black colored earrings, these earrings in the right pictures are all made of nephrite. According to chemical analysis, among these nephrite made earrings, it is now clear that some of them were made using Taiwanese nephrite. And it is also interesting that a flat earring is included among the egg style in the upper left part of the right picture. This one is similar to the major earring type found at the Penan site. These two pictures show the finding at Hoi An in central Vietnam. Except for the black colored earring at the right end of the right picture, the other earrings were all made of nephrite, and a large part of them were probably made using Taiwanese nephrite. The black colored earrings were made from glass, so we already know a certain part of the surfing culture's earrings have a very close relation with Taiwan. In the third chapter, I will explain the condition of similar earrings found in the site outside of Vietnam, such as in two places in southern Thailand, a site in East Malaysia, and four sites in the Philippines. For the first example, I will show you Samui Island off from the mainland of southern Thailand, which is shown in three pictures. In the present time, Samui Island is well known by foreign tourists as a good coastal resort island. But among the findings of archaeological research in this island were the surfing earrings, which have already been pointed out to be Taiwanese nephrite earrings. At the coastal area on the mainland of the southern Thailand, 130 kilometers northwest from Samui Island, is located an archaeological site named Khao Sam Khao, which is shown in these pictures. After research was conducted in this area, it was clear that there are findings of surfing earrings made by Taiwanese nephrite. These two sites are located at 800 km distance from Ho Chi Minh City, or 2,070 km from the south end of Taiwan. The next site is the Nia Cave, located in Sarawak, on the eastern part of Malaysia. This famous large cave opened at a high position on a vertical cliff, such as can be seen in the left picture. And the mouth of this cave is very wide, as can be seen in the right pictures. From extensive archaeological research, it is now clear that since the Mesolithic period, human beings continued to stay in this cave for a long period of time. These pictures show the condition inside of the cave. Among the findings from archaeological excavation within this cave was a surfing style earring, which also could be identified by chemical analysis as composed of Taiwanese nephrite. In the present time, the position of this cave is 40 km inland from the coast. However, in the prehistorical period, the distance from this cave to the coast was much closer, similar to another site in this area. A similar prehistoric cave site was found in Palawan Island in the Philippines. Tabon Cave is located on the west coast of this island and faces the South China Sea. The distance from here to the Nia Caves is measured at about 700 km, and to Ho Chi Minh City, it is about 1,200 km. The geographic condition of this cave is almost the same as with the Nia Cave, as seen in these pictures. The inside of this cave is also very wide, and from the sunshine which enters through its entrance area, it is also quite clear to see inside. As like the condition of the Nia Cave, this cave was also inhabited by human beings for a long time. This was also an area in which prolonged period of archaeological research were carried out, and as a result, a massive number of artifacts were found here, which include some surfing style earrings. These pictures show the archaeological findings of the surfing type earring from the four sites in the Philippines, which includes the Tabon Cave. The light drawings show the findings of the Tabon Cave, which has three types of surfing earrings. It is quite interesting that the flat type of the bottom light are more similar to earring of Penang, and the egg type of Taiwanese nephrite earring have also been found in Philippines, as can be seen in the middle pictures. Glass earring with sharp projections are shown in the left picture. If we see the finding of surfing earring in Lanyu Island, Taiwan, it is clear that an earring trade connection was already established around the South China Sea area, which included Taiwan. As additional information regarding Austronesians, I will introduce another nephrite culture, that of the Maori people of New Zealand. The left painting was already used in the Tato part of this course, but we should pay attention this time to the light green colored tool held in her right hand, And in another painting of a Maori king in the light picture, we can see he is holding a tool of similar color and shape. This tool is a ceremonial arm of Nephilite. The left picture is of a shape of Nephilite called mele. It was manufactured from a good color of Nephilite, and Maori people also used Nephilite jewelry, such as seen in the light pictures. New Zealand had a mine of Nephilite, and the arrival of Maori people here from around Tahiti was estimated to occur during the 9th century AD. Besides Maori, no other Polynesian group had a Nephilite culture. By such a condition, it is clear that the Nephilite culture of the Maori had no relation with Taiwan. But it is also interesting that this culture was also found among Austronesians. Keeping this fact in mind, we can't forget that there was a prehistorical exchange between Taiwan and the other Southeast Asian cultures, which is clear from the material evidence provided by the exchange of Nephilite.